Hey, welcome back, everyone. Today we'll be doing an 8-month check-in on the Bravestar raw leather belt that I purchased, well, about 8 months ago. And the reason I'm doing an 8-month check-in and not a 6-month check-in, like I had said, is, well, life happens, we get busy. And anyway, I just want to get some more wears on it. So it's been about 8+ months since I bought this belt. And I'm just going to kind of go over the things that I went over in the first video. The size of this belt is a size 28. I wear a size 30 in Bravestar and a size 32 in Levi's, and this thing fits me really great. All right. These unfinished edges were some things that I noticed people commented on some of the reviews, not that I posted, but in reviews I looked up of the belt. All right. I think these are pretty cool, and the more you wear it, the more these are going to smooth out. And again, this is going to be a really unique belt by the time it's finished, and I think that's part of it. Another thing I liked, I pointed out when I purchased this belt, were the holes here. I felt these were punched really nice, and they're not cheap. And one real sign of that is after all this wear, I always put it on the second loop. It's still roughly the same size. It's not stretched out, and this belt has not stretched out. All right, it still does a great job of holding my jeans in place where I want them. And that's notice another thing on here around the belt, the hole here where I always put my belt, or I put the belt through, is the oil from my fingers has really colored this belt, really nice brown color here. All right, you can see that's one of the more pronounced colors here, the patina, as you would see. And going along here, you'll kind of see some of the other markings from the wear and tear of wearing this every day. All right, some things maybe where like I spilled something or I was working and my belt got wet. Has really its own characteristics. No one else's belt is going to look like this. This will be completely mine forever. Now, another kind of cool thing I noticed, and I did not notice this until I started doing this tutorial, this video, is that where the belt rests all the time, where the tip rests, has been kind of protected. So that's pretty unique. That's really cool. I like that. The Bravestar and the Bravestar logo right here, the Bravestar words. Again, really nice patina, I feel, because of the oils from my finger always touching this to put the belt on. Really cool here as well. And then you have the antique brass belt buckle. This is holding up really nice. Now, one thing I said in my first video is that this belt buckle is removable. I stand corrected. It is not. But I have no issue with that. I think it looks really cool. And again, this is my everyday belt. I don't need anything fancy. Now, let's take a look at just the whole thing again. I think we'll just kind of go through here. I think over time, this is going to take on more and more characteristic and coloring. Now, I have not put any, leather protector or anything like that to color this belt. This is how this belt has turned out from me wearing it every day and just getting the oil from my body and my skin on this as I wear it. I hope this video helped. I hope other people want to share what they did with their belts, because I think this is pretty fun. And I think this was $38, so it didn't even cost a whole lot, and you get a real quality belt. So that's been my 8-month check-in of the Bravestar raw leather belt. I'm going to put this on and I'll do, show you what it looks like with some jeans that I have. I'll use the same pair that I wore when I did this video. And yeah, so stick around. Okay, as promised, I told you I put on the jeans I wore when I did this demo, the unboxing and review 8 months ago. So these are the same 15-ounce slim taper Bravestars that I wore at the time of the unboxing. So let's just take a quick spin around, see how it looks, and I'll move up closer and we can take a look. So from a distance, this belt doesn't pop as being as white. When I first put this on, it was really white and it really stood out. One thing also you can see is how the belt is getting a little closer to the age of the leather patch. All right, I'll do this, show the belt here. Now, obviously, they're never going to catch up to each other because I wear these jeans all the time, and I wear the belt all the time. But what's really cool is seeing the patina of the belt kind of catch up with the patch, right? That's just kind of something cool that I like. So now let's take a look at the belt up close. All right, I'm gonna come in, and I'll tilt the camera down, and we'll just take a look at how it looks. So as you see here, I put the belt on like this, so it makes sense as to why this spot and this spot have so much patina on it because my oils from my fingers are always touching here. Unbuckle, unbutton, you know, all day. Let's spin around and just take a closer look. We'll look at that patch again. All right, so this has aged a lot more, but so has the belt. And it's starting to not look as big of a contrast. It actually looks really good, I think, with that patch. Spinning around here, we see all this. And again, as I had talked about earlier in this video, the belt is not stretched out to a point where now I'm on the third loop. I still use the second loop on this belt, and I think it does a great job of holding up my jeans. So overall, my impressions 8 months in on the BraveStar Raw Leather Belt is it's a quality product. It was a good purchase. I would purchase this again. And I might purchase it again and use some leather conditioner on it and see what kind of color I get at that point. But other than that, I recommend this belt, especially for the price point, all right? Like, if you follow my channel, you know I don't have a ton of money. So when I buy something, I want it to work for a while, and I want it to be quality. This meets the criteria. So if this video helps, make sure you like and subscribe. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Otherwise, hope everyone's doing great. See you later.